Hey Saints, Sister with a Testimony. I'm in the field with Sister Janetta, Sister with a Testimony, Church Chat Grannie. Brother Mitchum said I had to come by and share my testimony. He does not care to be on camera, so we're just going to video, well, maybe the traffic today. It's kind of busy out here today on the corner, and we're not in Winslow, Arizona. I promise you, we're on the corner of Texarkana, Arkansas at Hickory and 9. And we are praying for people, and God is being glorified. Listen to Brother Mitchum's testimony. Praise the Lord.
January 2018, I had 2 massive strokes, a brain infection, and I broke my neck. Doctor said I wouldn't walk out of the hospital.
The devil's a liar.
What'd you say?
The devil's a liar.
That was it. People came, prayed over me, and here I am. I've got amnesia from it, but that's the Lord keeping it away from
me. That's right. You don't need it.
It was a wonderful experience, and I've actually saved people from harming themselves hearing what I've said. So.
Well, we want to encourage you to tell your testimony. Tell us again what happened to you. I want to make sure we get this right.
January 2018.
January 2018, 2 years ago.
Yes, ma'am. Two years ago, I had 2 massive strokes, a brain infection, and I broke my neck.
How did you break your neck?
It started in a car accident, but when they life-flighted me to Little Rock, I was in the hospital, got up in the middle of the night, went to take a shower, ended up falling in the shower.
In the hospital?
In the hospital. Broke my neck worse. That released a clot, which gave me the strokes.
Say again?
That released a clot in my neck from a perforated artery.
Okay.
And when they went to put shunts in my head to relieve the swelling in my brain, one of them was dirty, which gave me the brain infection.
So the enemy tried to kill you
in the hospital.
Once, twice, that's three times. I remember praying earlier speaking at 5 times. So you've had actually more experiences.
Oh yeah, I've had quite a few before that. In my 20s, I had my appendix burst on me. He's actually been after me for a long time.
But he can't have you anymore.
God's got plans.
Can I show that tattoo?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is the tattoo that our brother has sported. And I got to speak about this tattoo. He said, what, did you tell me that everything that I said was true?
Yes, ma'am.
And basically, when I was speaking over what body art that he had written on his body, I seen a journey that this man is on, Brother Mitchum. And as I was praying and the Lord was downloading to me, he said he's on a journey out of the pit of hell, literally like a bat out of hell. That's what came to me. And as he came into the light and the Lord changed his mind, you can see, turn over, the dove. And as I started just hearing the Lord say that I am the one that transforms you. I'm the one that transforms you from the pit of hell where you're dead in your sins and trespasses. And I don't mean that you're literally in hell, but your mind, your will, your soul, your emotions, you are literally dead in your trespasses and sins. But he has taken Mitchum out of that hell, like a bat out of hell. And he's transformed him into that dove on the wings of a snow white dove. And he said, I am going to seat you in heavenly places with myself as you already are. Now it's time for you to know that. Saints, this is not just for me. He came here today to share his testimony so that you would get saved. So I want you, Mitchum, to tell them what you want for them. Why did you come give us your testimony? Because you're not on camera.
I just came to, I had a feeling to come over here and talk to you ladies. And anytime I see somebody, I'll stop and if they're strangers, I'll tell them my testimony. Because I want everybody to come to the Lord. I pray for the unbelievers every night.
Amen.
I pray for them that somebody will plant a seed in their life.
You're a seed planter.
I hope somebody sows it one of these days.
Well, somebody sowed seed into you, brother.
Yes, they did.
And now they're getting the harvest.
I pray for the missionaries and all that that goes over. But we need a missionaries here.
Yes. We're here.
That's what we're doing.
You're right where you need to be. Stance,
yes,
Arkansas,
ma'am.
Louisville, all of that
is
demonic. All of that is generational curses over there.
Yes.
And you can do it. You're,
my friend, that preacher down
there,
Sunday night, he does jail ministry. He goes out, you know, he does it.
I've lived over there.
Yes.
I know.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, ma'am.
And
well,
you can be yes.
Say it. Tell him.
Yes.
She got something to say.
The Lord can absolutely use you over there. You get in the Word, and because you're going to be against religion. religion is very, very strong over there.
Yeah.
And they believe once saved, always saved. No. No, you cannot be saved and live for Jesus and continue in your drinking,
right.
your fornication. Read 1 Corinthians 6. You cannot. Right. And that whole area needs the Holy Spirit to fall right. over there, and the truth will set you free.
Yep.
And that's what you and your friends and the preacher.
That's what we're doing.
That's
do
what
it.
You, do it.
Well, I just want to bless you, Miss Janetta.
Yes.
Will you pray for Brother Mitchum
yes,
before he
Lord.
Leaves?
We just give you the honor and the glory, and we thank you, Father God, that your spirit is in Mitchum. You told him to come over here, Father God, and I pray that he will listen to your voice, Father God, and get rid of any other voices, because they're the other voices is going to keep him from walking that narrow path, Father God. And I pray, Father God, that you have planted him in the right area, the right season, because he's wanting souls, Father God. He's wanting to save souls, Father God, in your name. And we pray, Father God, that he will just continue in your word, because your word is a two-edged sword. It fights any devil. And that is what has been spoken over there, is the wrong words. And I just thank you, Father, that you have sent him here. I pray for Jeremy. I pray for Sherry, Father God, because they're going to be used. And the devil's going to come, but they win the blood. I plead and ply the blood of Jesus over them, Father God. No weapon formed against them will prosper. Any tongue that comes against them will be condemned. That's what it says in your word in Isaiah 54, Father God. And I thank you for that, Father God. I thank you for Mitchum, Father God, for what you've got for him, Father God, because he's going to be walking in your plan and purpose for him. And I pray, Father, that any time the pressure starts coming and whatever, that he will go and seek righteous people to pray for him, Father God, because we all need to be around righteous spirits, Father God. And I give you the honor and the glory, and I thank you for today, Father God. I thank you that you have sent him here, Father God, for this time and this season, for him to go on and do what you have for him. We give you the honor and the glory, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Amen. Amen.
Father God, thank you. Thank you. Brother Mitchum, bless him before you leave. And I'm not videoing you.
I bless everybody out there, and I want anybody that's a lost soul to please find someone and just start studying the word and start realizing why we're here.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen and amen in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, who is Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. And Father God, we thank you.
His
sisters with a testimony, soldier with a testimony, Mitchum. God bless you. We love you, brother.